Okay, so we are going to look at impulse daily practice problem number one. And it reads, at the Stout Baseball Double Header against UW-LaCrosse, one of our very own Blue Devils hit a line drive off a pitch. The velocity of the pitch was 35 meters per second towards the batter. We're going to say it was traveling purely horizontally. The baseball, which has a mass of 0.145 kilograms, stayed in contact with the bat for 0.04 seconds and left the bat with a speed of 50 meters per second, again, purely horizontally, away from the batter. What was the average force exerted on the ball? All right, so this is an impulse problem. We're looking at how the momentum of the ball changed and what the force was that caused that change. So the first thing we're going to identify is the object, and we are interested in that ball. And with an impulse problem, a momentum problem, we want to think about what defines the initial when that interaction is happening and what defines the final when that interaction is over, so during the time of the change of momentum. We like to draw some pictures, so there's our baseball bat. That's not good. And we will have the ball coming into the baseball bat. And then after the ball leaves the baseball bat, we have our returning. So that's our initial and final condition. Then we can look at the properties of momentum related to this object. So we have the mass of the ball initial and the velocity of the ball initial. And then we have the mass of the ball final and velocity of the ball final. So the mass of the ball, we are told it's 145 grams, so 0.145 kilograms initially, and that doesn't change. So in the final condition, we have 145 kilograms as well. It tells us that the ball was pitched with a velocity of 35 meters per second. Now, as I've drawn it, that ball is moving to the left. So that's going to be a negative 35 meters per second. Momentum is a vector, so we have to remember that direction is important, and it's going to be important as we continue to look at this problem and future problems. All right, it tells us that the ball leaves purely horizontally at 50 meters per second. And because that's moving to the right, that is a positive velocity. So that is our information relative to when the momentum change is happening, right before, right at the beginning of that change, and then when it is over. So the question asks us to look at the average force. And force is what's causing the change of momentum through our impulse relationship. So the impulse, the change in momentum, is the force times the time. That impulse is also defined as my change in momentum, or P final minus P initial. So my final momentum, well, that's our mass, final mass, times final velocity, minus my initial momentum. So we have 0.145 times 50 minus 0.145 times negative 35. So the direction is in play for both my velocities, and we can calculate the momentum. So taking out our handy dandy calculator there, we have 0.145 times 50. So that has a momentum of 7.25 minus 0.145 times negative 35. We get a minus 5.075. Those two added together, 5.075 plus 7.25, and we end up with a momentum change, or an impulse, of 12.325. And that, bringing down our force times our time, we're told that this interaction happens in 0.04 seconds. So during that time of 0.04 seconds, the bat is in contact with the ball applying the force. So we have our force times 0.04 equals 12.325, dividing both sides by 0.04, and we get a force of 308 newtons. So pretty strong force for our little baseball player. All right, so looking back at what we examined, our object is the ball. The ball has an initial change that has an initial momentum coming into the bat based on its mass and its velocity. It has a final momentum leaving the bat based on its mass and its velocity. We are keeping in mind direction as I've drawn it. Initially, it's moving to the left, and finally, it's moving to the right. We look at that change in momentum. That change in momentum is, in fact, the impulse. It's related to the force times the time that force is being applied. We're told that the ball is in contact with the bat for 0.04 seconds, and we can solve for the force. Good job.